With me, Ayushman Singh Jamwal. Ladies and gentlemen, big breaking news coming in where Prime Minister Narendra Modi has once again attacked the Congress party for its wealth redistribution promise. This is referring to Rahul Gandhi's pitch that there will be an institutional survey when it comes to wealth distribution across the nation. This is what Rahul Gandhi has pitched, and Prime Minister Modi has now accused the Congress of a plot to loot the people of India, claiming that the party plans to loot citizens across the country for the sake of appeasement politics, also referring to former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh's statement from back in 2006, where he said that the first right to the nation's resources belongs to the minorities of the nation, especially Muslims. Prime Minister Modi even saying that the opposition will target the ancestral wealth of citizens across the country, even the gold as well as the Mangal Sutras of women across the nation. Prime Minister Modi doubling down on this big charge against the Congress party as the elections kick off. Ladies and gentlemen, Prime Minister Modi made this emphatic pitch in Aligarh in Uttar Pradesh. Listen in.
मैं देशवासियों को आगाह करना चाहता हूं, कांग्रेस और इंडी गठबंधन की नजर अब आपकी कमाई पर है, आपकी संपत्ति पर है। कांग्रेस के शहजादे का कहना है कि उनकी सरकार आई तो कौन कितना कमाता है, किसके पास कितनी प्रॉपर्टी है, किसके पास कितना धन है, किसके पास कितने मकान है, उसकी जांच कराएंगे। इतना ही नहीं, वो आगे कहते हैं कि ये जो संपत्ति है उनको सरकार अपने कब्जे में लेकर उसको सबको बांट देगी।
And as the war of words continues to escalate, I'm joined by my colleagues Aman Sharma as well as Pallavi Ghosh on the broadcast. So, Aman, earlier it was thought that this was a pitch primarily in Rajasthan, given the fact Prime Minister said that infiltrators will be handed over the wealth of citizens, saying that this was a Congress plot, given the fact that Rajasthan is a border state. But it seems that this is going to be a wider narrative strategy coming in from the BJP to take on the India Alliance.
Well, yes, Ayushman, this is a bigger pitch by the BJP. They are attacking what the Rahul Gandhi has promised on April 6th in his statement in Hyderabad. They are clearly saying that what is this whole financial and institutional survey which Rahul Gandhi has promised? What is this all about? How are you going to assess the wealth of every person in India? How are you going to redistribute it amongst those who you think do deserve that wealth? That is what the Prime Minister is now asking, that what is the basis of this entire survey? What is the Congress really talking about? Is this even constitutional, for example? You know, is such an exercise even there in our constitution? How will the Congress embark on this? This is what Rahul Gandhi had very clearly said on April 6th in Hyderabad in his speech, while the Congress manifesto was being launched, that first the Congress will do a caste census, then a socio and economic survey, which will be followed by what he called a revolutionary step of a financial and institutional survey to assess who has how much wealth and how that wealth can go to people that Rahul Gandhi felt need that wealth. How will that exercise carry out? The Prime Minister is carrying his attack from Rajasthan to today, also again bringing up that issue that the Mangal Sutra of people, the Sridhan of people, will be taken away by the Congress party if they come to power, and they will then decide who this wealth goes to. So this is a larger pitch by the BJP now. Though in this speech today, the Prime Minister has also spoken about the Muslim community. The Prime Minister has said that, you know, it's the Pasmanda Muslims who have been ignored for a long time by the SP and the BSP in Uttar Pradesh, which have indulged in appeasement politics. His government has cared for them. His government is the one which abolished triple talaq, which has benefited Muslim women. He also said he spoke to the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia personally to get the quota of the Hajj pilgrims increased so that Indian Muslims can go to Hajj in bigger numbers. So in a way, the Prime Minister also saying what all he has done for the Muslim community and how the earlier governments were basically doing Muslim appeasement for vote bank politics. But the major attack on the Congress party and on Rahul Gandhi's statement of this survey that he has promised is continuing from Mr. Modi. And this will be the constant theme now, because the Congress, the onus now, the Prime Minister is throwing the onus on the Congress party to actually explain what this entire wealth redistribution plan is all about, which the Congress leader, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, has spoken while launching the manifesto.
Absolutely. And while the Prime Minister accuses the Congress party of appeasement politics, he's also putting out his track record of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, primarily towards the Muslim community across the country. Before I go to Pallavi, let's listen in to what Mallikarjun Kharge, Congress chief, has reacted when it comes to Prime Minister Modi's pitch of this wealth redistribution strategy of the Congress party, which Prime Minister claims is a ploy to loot the people of India for appeasement politics. Let's listen in to what Kharge had to say.
The AE, jo aadmi apni himmat kho leta hai, और जिसके पास बोलने के लिए कुछ मुद्दे नहीं हैं तो ऐसी चीज़ें लाते हैं। अगर उनके पास उनके ठोस मुद्दे हैं, ठोस काम हैं, वो बता सकते हैं। जैसा कि हमने नरेगा का बताते हैं, फूड सिक्योरिटी का बताते हैं, कंपलसरी एजुकेशन का बताते हैं, आरटीए का बताते हैं और रूरल हेल्थ मिशन का बताते हैं। यह हमने किया है, हम बता वैसा काम उन्होंने कहने दो जो जनता के भलाई के लिए और सबके लिए है। तो उनके पास कुछ नहीं बोलने के लिए, वो हमेशा कांग्रेस को टीका करते हैं या अपोजिशन, और ख़ास करके आजकल तो ये बोल रहे हैं कि इंडिया गठबंधन वहाँ कुछ भी नहीं है, कोई लीडर नहीं है। अरे लीडर गठबंधन में लीडर पैदा होता है बाद में, पहले ही थोड़ा ही करते हैं, कभी भी ऐसा नहीं हुआ।
लेकिन जो मैनिफेस्टो कांग्रेस का है वो सबसे स्ट्रॉन्ग साउंड है इस चुनाव में कांग्रेस पार्टी का। उस पर लगातार जिस तरीके से खुद बीजेपी ने हमला किया कि ये मुस्लिम लीग टाइप का मैनिफेस्टो लग रहा है, इसके पीछे क्रोनोलॉजी क्या रहा होगा?
देखो हमने बताओ, मैंने बताया यहाँ पर कौन सा मुस्लिम लीग का इश्यू है। उसमें सबको, सब महिला को एक एक लाख रुपये सालाना देना, ये मुस्लिम लीग का है प्रोग्राम। युवाओं को नौकरी देना, ट्रेनिंग देना और उनको एक लाख रुपए ट्रेनिंग के लिए देना, ये मुस्लिम लीग का है। और किसानों के लिए हम उनकी लीगल गारंटी MSP पे करेंगे, ये क्या किसानों का, ये क्या मुस्लिम लीग का है। SC ST को और बैकवर्ड्स को जो बैकलॉग है और जो सरकार वैकेंसी है वो फिलअप करने के लिए हमने वायदा किया, क्या वो मुस्लिम लीग का है? बोलो आप कौन सा मुस्लिम लीग का है। अरे 25 गारंटी हमने जो दी सबके लिए दिए हैं, गरीब के लिए है, महिला के लिए है, युवाओं के लिए है, दलित के लिए है, सबके लिए हमने दिया है। और जो चीज़ें सबको मिलते हैं वो हर एक को मिलते।
So that is the pitch coming in from the Congress chief, I'm joined by my colleague Pallavi Ghosh on the broadcast. So Pallavi, when it comes to Rahul Gandhi's statement from Hyderabad that there will be a financial and institutional survey on wealth distribution, is the Congress giving more ammunition to the BJP by not clarifying what this financial and institutional survey on wealth distribution actually entails? Because it seems that given the grey area surrounding that, the BJP is mobilizing what former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh said in 2006 and mobilizing this entire appeasement charge against the Congress party.
Well, Ayushman, to be very fair, the Congress party has clarified, and in fact on the day that Nyay Patra was released, these were specific questions which were asked. They never said that they are going to talk only about the Muslims. That's the clarification which is still coming in from the Congress, and that's also the reason why they want to spread out the copies of the manifesto to the Prime Minister himself and to an election commission where the copies of the manifesto will be distributed. What they did say at the manifesto release was that we think that a present system of distribution of wealth is and resources is not not equitable. It only has gone and concentrated in the hands of few people, few corporates, and those who are considered to be friendly to the regime or close to the Prime Minister and to the BJP. That is something which we really want to change. That is something also what Rahul Gandhi referred to when he was speaking at that particular event. But apart from that, in the multiple press conferences, that's how he has justified the caste census. That the caste census is important because we really need to know that the backwards, the downtrodden, the ones who have been left out, what is their number, what amount of access do they have to the resources and to the wealth, and that can only happen once we have that census, that survey comes across, and then we are going to redraw the entire...